Legal News, 14th May to 20th May 2018 by Deepak Miglani. Income Tax Department seeks Flipkart sale agreement with Walmart. The Income Tax Department will seek the share purchase agreement from Flipkart on the mega $16 billion buyout by U.S. retail giant Walmart. The move is a part of a plan to assess the tax liability and to find out whether general anti-avoidance rules provisions can be invoked. The department currently is going through Section 19 Subclause 1 of the Income Tax Law, which deals with indirect transfer provisions, to see if the benefits under the bilateral tax treaties with countries like Singapore and Mauritius could be available for foreign investors selling stakes to Walmart. Singapore-registered Flipkart holds a majority stake in Flipkart India. Uttarakhand High Court tells government to amend IPC frame rules under State Police Act 2007 for better witness protection. A bench of Justice Rajiv Sharma and Justice Alok Singh and directed the state government to frame rules under Section 54 of the Uttarakhand Police Act 2007 dealing with the protection of witnesses within 6 months, and also make suitable amendment in the Indian Penal Code to punish the persons inducing any witness to give false statement. Women governed by Muslim personal law can invoke provisions of Domestic Violence Act and seek relief, Bombay High Court. In a significant judgment, the Bombay High Court has held that merely because parties are governed by the Muslim personal law, it should not be an important in the wife invoking provisions of the Domestic Violence Act. Justice Bharti Dangde also held there is no embargo on a court to grant relief to a woman who is an aggrieved person within the meaning of the Domestic Violence Act merely because she is a Muslim. Tell the Nation what happened to Lal Bahadur Shastri. Central Information Commission tells PMO, MEA and MHA. While doubts being raised over the mysterious death of India's second Prime Minister Lal Bahadur Shastri till recent times, the Central Information Commission has directed the PMO, the Ministry of External Affairs and the Ministry of Home Affairs to provide details about his death and also trace the findings of the Raj Narayan Inquiry Commission's probe into circumstances leading to his death. Why no ban on hospitals forcing people to buy medicines only from their in-house pharmacies, Supreme Court. The practice of private hospitals compelling patients to buy medicines only from their in-house pharmacies at inflated prices has come under the judicial scanner, with the Supreme Court six from the center and states on why it should not be banned. A bench of Justices S. A. Bobde and L. Nageshwar Rao agreed to hear a PIL filed by Vijay Pal Dalmia, alleging that he had to pay more than ₹20,000 more for each bacillitis injection purchased from hospitals when Dalmia's wife was being treated for breast cancer. ITNs move Supreme Court for scrapping of Section 377 of IPC. Days after hotelier Keshav Suri, who runs the Lalit Group of Hotels, approached the Supreme Court for decriminalizing gay sex, a batch of 20 current and former students of Indian Institute of Technology has filed a petition in court saying criminalization of sexual orientation resulted in a sense of shame, loss of self-esteem and stigma. The petitioners belong to different parts of the country and are well established in their professional lives. Some of them are scientists, teachers, entrepreneurs and researchers and are of different age groups. Supreme Court orders auction of Unitex 600 acres. The Supreme Court ordered auction of over 600 acres belonging to Unitec in Agra and Varanasi in UP and Shri Pem Budur in Tamil Nadu, as it sensed home buyers' frustration over refund of their money invested in the builders' delayed housing projects. A bench of Chief Justice Deepak Mishra and Justice A.M. Khanwilkar and D.Y. Chandrachud constituted a committee headed by former Delhi High Court Judge S.N. Dhingra and authorized him to nominate a chartered accountant and valuer accredited with the Supreme Court or the Delhi High Court. It said Justice Dhingra would formulate terms and conditions for auction of the land. Ceiling relief in Delhi, Supreme Court allows changes in Master Plan 2021. In a big relief to all those facing the ceiling drive in Delhi on illegal constructions and business running from residential premises, the Supreme Court allowed the center to proceed with amending the Master Plan 2021 but directed it to invite objections from residents and take a final call only after considering them. A bench of Justices Madan B. Lokur and Naveen Sinha directed the center to publish its proposed amendments in the master plan in leading newspapers and grant 15 days time to the residents to file their objections. Delhi High Court directs CBI to probe assault on Tihar inmates. The Delhi High Court directed the CBI to investigate the allegations of assault and physical torture on several prisoners lodged in the high-risk ward of Tihar Jail. Acting Chief Justice Geeta Mittal and Justice C. Harishankar said prisons officials do not need to resort to violent methods to manage their jails, and just because a person in uniform is inflicting the violence, the act does not get decriminalized. The court consequently directed jail officials to forward to the CBI all records as well as reports of two fact-finding committees set up to look into the incident of November 21, 2017 when 18 prisoners were allegedly beaten up by the prison staff. Navjot Singh Sidhu let off by Supreme Court with fine of Rs 1000 in road rage case. In a big relief to cricketer turned politician and Punjab minister Navjot Singh Sidhu, the Supreme Court let him off with a fine of Rs 1000 in a 1998 road rage case in which one person died, saying there was no evidence to prove that the death was caused by the single blow he dealt. A bench of Justices J. Chelmeshwar and Sanjay Kishan Kaul set aside the verdict of the Punjab and Haryana High Court, which had convicted Sidhu for culpable homicide, not amounting to murder, and had awarded 3 years jail. On December 27, 1988, Sidhu and his friend Rupinder Singh Sandhu had got into an argument with one Gurnam Singh over parking space in Patiala. The duo allegedly dragged Singh out of his car and hit him. Singh later died. A session court acquitted Sidhu and Sandhu in 1999, but the order was quashed by the High Court, which convicted them and awarded them a 3-year jail term in 2006. The two approached the Supreme Court, which stayed their conviction. Supreme Court Collegium recommends additional judge of Rajasthan High Court to be made permanent. The Supreme Court Collegium recommended that Justice Ramchandra Singh Jhala, additional judge of Rajasthan High Court, be made permanent. The collegium comprising Chief Justice of India Deepak Mishra, Justice J. Chelmeshwar and Justice Ranjan Gogoi had 4 other names of additional judges of the High Court before it as well. No attendance relaxation for pregnancy during LLB course, Delhi High Court. The Delhi High Court refused to grant attendance relaxation to a second-year student of the LLB course of Faculty of Law, University of Delhi, who had missed college due to her pregnancy. While Justice Rekha Pali noted that there may be justification for the petitioner's inability to attend regular classes, she ruled that the relief cannot be granted in light of the rules of legal education of the Bar Council of India as well as earlier decisions of the High Court. The petitioner, Mrs. Ankita Meena, had sought a direction to Delhi University to permit her to appear in the 4th semester LLB examination. She could not meet the requisite 70% attendance criteria, having missed almost 2 months of the semester due to her pregnancy. Would not allow arrest of innocents even if government makes law to dilute the arrest clause in the SC/ST Act, Supreme Court. Toughening its stand against a plea to review its ruling diluting the arrest clause in the Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribes Prevention of Atrocities Act, the Supreme Court said it would not allow arrest of an innocent merely on a complaint even if Parliament made such a law. First sitting High Court judge to be jailed for contempt, Justice Kannan set to launch his political party. Calcutta High Court's former judge, Justice C.S. Kannan, who was once jailed for contempt by the Supreme Court and retired while absconding, has announced the launch of his political party to contest the 2019 general elections. Justice Kannan has named his political party Anti-Corruption Dynamic Party and has announced that it would be contesting polls in 2019 from seats across India, including Varanasi, the constituency of Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Supreme Court directs Amrapali to deposit 250 crores. In a move to quicken relief for stranded home buyers, the Supreme Court directed the Amrapali Group to deposit 250 crores in 2 months and appointed a committee to supervise construction of its housing projects to ensure timely completion. A bench of Justice Arun Mishra and U.U. Lalit passed a slew of directions to protect interest of home buyers and allowed the beleaguered real estate giant to rope in other co-developers to complete the housing projects, as it is not in a situation to do so on its own due to financial difficulties. Despite settlement agreement, courts cannot compel party to consent to mutual divorce. Delhi High Court. In a significant judgment, the Delhi High Court asserted that courts cannot compel a party to give their consent for divorce by mutual consent despite them having entered into a settlement agreement under Section 13B of the Hindu Marriage Act. Jammu and Kashmir Governor promulgates ordinance on death penalty for rape of girls under 12 years of age. Jammu and Kashmir Governor Mr. Governor N.N. Vora has promulgated two ordinances prescribing stricter penalties for child rapists. As per an official release, the Jammu and Kashmir Criminal Law Amendment Ordinance 2018, Jammu and Kashmir Protection of Children from Sexual Violence Ordinance 2018 were promulgated. In view of the surge in violence against women in general and sexual violence in particular in various parts of the country, including the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Supreme Court allows Karthi to fly abroad but with riders. The Supreme Court allowed Karthi Chidambaram, son of Congress P. Chidambaram, to travel to the UK, Germany and Spain with certain conditions, including that he would not open or close any bank account abroad. Karthi, facing probe by the ED and the CBI in cases including one relating to FIPB clearance to INX Media for receiving foreign funds to the tune of rupees 305 crore when his father was finance minister, has been allowed to go abroad from tomorrow till May 27. Supreme Court okays Kaveri plan, wants it in place by monsoon. The Supreme Court approved the center's draft Kaveri management scheme for distribution of water among Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Puducherry and asked it to be put in force before the onset of the impending monsoon. A bench of Chief Justice Deepak Mishra and Justices A.M. Khanwilkar and D.Y. Chandrachud said the scheme is in consonance with its February 16 judgment and turned down the plea of Karnataka and Kerala, which had raised objections. The court said, "We cannot allow the parties to reopen the issues already settled in the award and as modified by this court in the guise of questioning the appropriateness of some clause in the draft scheme." Note must that senior most MLA has to be pro tem speaker, Supreme Court. The Supreme Court told the Congress JDS combined that convention of the senior most MLA being named the pro tem speaker had no legal force and pointed to past instances to reject the challenge to K.G. Bopayya's appointment as pro tem speaker in the Karnataka Assembly. Bombay High Court imposes 50,000 fine on CBI for arrest of women after sunset. The Bombay High Court recently slapped a fine of rupees 50,000 on the Central Bureau of Investigation for an illegal arrest made by its officer in the PNB fraud case. The bench comprising Justice S.J. Kathawala and Justice Bharti Dangde, however, clarified that agency is free to recover this cost from the erring officers responsible for the violations as found after disciplinary proceedings. The court was hearing a petition filed by one Mrs. Kavita Manikar, who had alleged that she was arrested in violation of Section 46, Subclause 4 of the Code of Criminal Procedure. The provision bars arrest of women after sunset and before sunrise. As per the provision, such arrest can only be made in exceptional circumstances, and that too after a women police officer obtains prior permission from judicial magistrate first class. Please like the video, share the video and subscribe the YouTube channel. Thank you.